You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Hello, Bishop Wooden here. I'm excited. I'm back in the office getting ready for tonight, and I want to talk to you about freedom, freedom in Christ. Now, the title of the message will be different, a little different from that, you know, but, you know, everybody's talking about being free and freedom that's in Christ Jesus, and how the Lord sets us free. He certainly doesn't want us bound and worried and bogged down and jaded and afraid. He in fact wants us free in Him. But my question is, what does being free mean? What was the Lord talking about in John chapter 8 and verse 32? And He says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Free to do what? Free to behave how? Free. What does it mean to be free? Is it freedom to do anything we want with whomever? Or is the Lord saying something else? Well, I want to talk to you tonight, my friends, about liberty. Our liberty that we have in Christ, our freedom that we have in Christ, and what we're free to do in Christ and free to be. This is the year of the pressers. See, many of us are recognizing the value of being saved, recognizing the value and the blessing of being a born-again Christian and serving God according to biblical Christianity. And the most dangerous place in the world right now for many of us is for you to stand between us and our Savior, or us and the kingdom of God that is in the earth and our God-given assignments, because we recognize that we are fortunate to be saved and in the church serving the God of the Bible in a day like today. I am grateful to be saved. I'm glad to be in holiness. I love being a holiness preacher. I love serving the Lord in the beauty, the scripture says, in the beauty of holiness. I love the Bible. I love being a churchman. I'm grateful that the Lord saved me when He did, spared my life, and put me in the church. Yes, in the body of Christ in general, in the church of God in Christ in particular, being a holiness preacher. I love it, and I'm free, and I want to talk to you about it. And there are others who are just, we recognize how privileged, I think that's the word I was searching for, how the privilege it is to serve the Lord. And you know what? We're pressing into it. We're pressing into it. We're telling the devil, nor you nor your kingdom is going to stand between us and the kingdom of God, which is in our hearts. But at the same time, the enemy will do all he can to try to block you and stop you. So tonight, I want you to come out. We have quite a few passages of scripture that we want to study. I actually wish I could do two or three chapters on the subject, but we're going to cram it and condense it in. So I want you to be on time. We're going to walk in the scriptures, and we're going to talk about our liberty that we have in Christ. We have been liberated. We have been set free. We've been redeemed. We've been purchased. But free to do what? That's what I want to talk to you about tonight. Meet me here.